My son is on Snapchat, which means I need to be on Snapchat. God. Ted Cruz's relationship with Donald Trump has been interesting to watch over the past few years. You'll remember, and if not, I'm about to remind you, that during the 2016 presidential campaign, Cruz was one of the most outspoken critics of one Donald Trump. He called Trump a sniveling coward. He called him a pathological liar. He said he was utterly amoral. He also pointedly refused to endorse Trump at the Republican National Convention that year. Trump wasn't blameless, don't act surprised. He suggested Cruz's wife was unattractive, that Cruz hid behind religion, and that Cruz's father might have been involved in the assassination of one John F. Kennedy. Yes, all of that actually really happened. The two Republicans did eventually make up, largely because Cruz bent over backward to make nice with Trump because he wanted to run for president again someday and knew that he could not do that if he was a sworn enemy of the former president. Cruz, over his time running against and then making up with Trump, has become an astute observer of both the former president and the space that the billionaire businessman occupies in the Republican Party these days. Witness what Cruz had to say about Trump and the 2024 race at the Texas Tribune Festival in late September. Watch.
You're not tethered to reality if you think it doesn't make a difference whether he chooses to run or not.
Cruz argued that it is utter garbage when Republican candidates pronounce that they will run in 2024 whether or not Trump decides to get into the race. And, but, he added this.
I'll tell you this, if he doesn't run, everybody runs. 2016, we had 17 Republican candidates. I think this time around, on the over-under, I'd take the over. I think we'll have 20 or more.
Here's the thing. Cruz is 100% right. Everything that happens, including Cruz campaigning recently in New Hampshire and Florida Senator Rick Scott happening to be in Iowa to stump for a House candidate earlier this month, everything that happens before Trump makes up his mind is a sort of pre-show. It's interesting and it's worth covering. But if Trump runs, and there's every indication that he will, then it likely does not matter. Trump has even said as much. In an October interview with Yahoo, Trump was asked about the prospect of facing Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, who has emerged as a conservative darling over the past 2 years.
I don't think I will face him because I don't see that. If I did it, I don't see that. I think most people would drop out. I think he would drop out. And if I faced him, I'd beat him like I would beat everyone else, frankly.
I'm slightly less convinced about Trump totally clearing the field and DeSantis getting out of his way. But what Trump is right about is that he is, right now, without question, the dominant figure within the Republican Party. There are pockets, sure, of anti-Trumpism within the GOP, but the 2022 primary season largely affirmed the tight grip that the former president still has over his party, which again, doesn't mean that no one will run against him if he launches a 2024 campaign. I could see DeSantis, former Vice President Mike Pence, former Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, and yes, even maybe Ted Cruz getting into a race with Trump in 2024. And it goes without saying, but I'm gonna say it anyway, that all of those people I just named would be for sure in the mix if Trump shocks the world and decides against running in that race. But the truth that Cruz exposes is that Trump remains the prime mover in Republican presidential politics. All roads lead to him in his eventual go or no-go decision. And until he makes it, the race doesn't really start for any other Republican. Trump's announcement timing has been all over the place in the last few months, although of late, it appears as though he's content to wait until after the midterms to make up his mind. Until he does so, the Republican field is frozen. And that is the point. If you enjoy these videos, please like and rate them.